Greetings YouTube, DJ Bonebreaker coming at you for my first ever Starfield ship build video. So without further ado, let's get right into it. So yes, this here is the Lunar Whale, which is a very heavily modified former Ecliptic mercenary, Ecliptic Stiletto, but without, you know, getting like special story quest rewards or unlocking like high-end ship building and piloting skill levels. This is probably one of the better ships that you can have because it's got decent hull, decent jump range, decent amount of cargo, decent weaponry, and you know, generally pretty good overall. Like, the hull of the ship's a bit banged up still from an encounter that I had while surveying the third planet of the Eridani system, when I got jumped by not one, not two, not three, but four Crimson Pirate Raiders. And I had to use a couple of ship part, you know, repair kits or whatever you call them, to survive it, but I managed to successfully destroy all four ships. I was hoping to capture the largest one, but unfortunately I went a little bit ham with the missiles and ended up destroying it before I could disable the engines, even though I'd locked onto the engines. But anyways, I'll give you a quick tour of the interior of the ship here to show how it's laid out. But yeah, as you can see, this ship has a pretty straightforward layout. You got the landing bay here, you got the docking adapter right here, and in the middle here we've got workshop in this lower deck. We got the weapon, industrial, and spacesuit workbench. The only thing that's missing is a research lab, but I mean, it's good for like quickly modifying and upgrading anything that you might want to keep, you know, after looting that umpteenth pirate outpost. But then you come upstairs, and up here is the cockpit. Got our, you know, cargo hold access here. And of course, the captain's locker, two crew seating, and your pilot seat. And then back here, this is a all-in-one berthing module, so you got like the crew lounge right here, sit out and chill and stuff. The galley here, which yet again we got a pan knocked on the floor, so yeah, this is where you can go take a bite to eat. And then back here in the rear of the module we've got four bunks and the all-important space crapper, so you can do your business in space. So yeah, like I said, fairly simple, straightforward layout. Has everything you could possibly want, for the most part, in a small ship. And this ship has 860 cargo capacity, which for a ship this size is pretty huge. So I'm going to go to the shipbuilder here as soon as I figure out where the ship builder is. Oh yeah, this way. And show you how to convert a standard Ecliptic Stiletto into this thing, because I happen to capture Ecliptic Stiletto just for the specific purpose of making this video. And some of the parts you need to for building and upgrading it are only available at Aquila City. So let's talk to this guy right here.
Anything I can help you with? Got anything you need to offload? Trade authority is always buying. Kiosk right here for you.
Well, first I need to repairs.
We're able to land it, so I'm sure whatever is broken can be fixed.
And
sure, I've added.
Review and modify. So this here is the Lunar Whale. So yeah, it's got these yeah, let's go into build mode. So yeah, as you can see, we've got 506 hull rating, 420 shield rating. I could boost it up to 440 if I replace this shield unit with one that attaches to the side, but I don't like the asymmetrical look, and it also decreased the mobility slightly and cost a significant amount more money. So yeah, I've got these two of these Titan 550 HE3 tanks, healing three tanks, which give a total of 320 fuel for jumping. So this thing's got a pretty massive jump range. Got this jump drive here, the R2000, which gives it 24 light years radius for a single jump. It's got two of these White Dwarf 2010 engines, which are the best of the like Starship engines that you can get. You know, like they're the same type of engines on your Starship, but they're the best you can get without investing points into Starship building or piloting. Because they're still Class A. Same with this reactor. This is the best reactor you can get for Class A that without, you know, any points in shipbuilding. So it gives 20 power output. And then I've got these A300 engines right here. MN3 engines right here for extra thrust. And then got this Hope Tech Hope 11 Docker, which is one of the parts that's exclusive to Aquila City. And these three Ravager 20 megavolt electron beams are also exclusive to Aquila City. Yeah, these two cargo modules here, the Caraval V-102, provide 300 cargo capacity each, and I replace the original Samurai cockpit with the Daimyo one to get like extra cargo space. So that's how we got 860 cargo. Yeah, I got two crew and two passenger capacity for this ship. So all in all, pretty good, small, heavily armed, fast, light freighter. Or I guess possibly even general purpose ship. So yeah, the three particle beams do 45 damage per shot to both hull and shields. And the three missile launchers do 141 damage to hull and shields. So yeah, that I don't see any purpose having a third weapon system, because these two are all you ever need pretty much for any encounter. Basically, I use the particle beams whenever in between the, you know, when the missiles pods are recharging or reloading, I guess you'd say. And then, you know, just when I go into the targeting mode, which is kind of like VATS for ships, that's when I hammer the missiles in if I want to destroy a ship. And this is the shield generator I use, the Dogstar shield here, 330S protector shield generator. Which, like I said, is the most powerful shields you can get that you can mount topside without needing point investment. The only shield that's better would be to, let's see, go in here. Yeah, it would be to this SG-30, which is 440. It's increased your shield health by 20. But like I said, it can only mount to the side. You can't mount to the top. So yeah, that's the build. So this is what it started out as, one of these bad boys. So I'll show you like a couple different options for like mods. So first you're gonna have to register it, obviously. So let's do that. It costs you almost 12,000 credits to register, which is a bit pricey, but not out of reach for someone who's still, you know, early game. So for the basic El Cheapo module, gonna do is delete these structural components here. Delete these fuel tanks, because while they're significantly better than what you normally be able to get without any ranks in Starship Design, they also are extremely heavy, so they slow you down quite a bit. So get rid of those, plus they're worth a decent amount of money. So as you can see, I'm already over 1,000 credits in the surplus towards rebuilding, then get rid of this these two middle landing modules. Get rid of the docker and this storeroom here. And then get rid of the two pulse lasers and the autocannons, because as you can see, the part, even the more basic particle beams, which I'll be showing you for the El Cheapo option, do more damage to the hull than these cannons do, and they do more damage to shields than these lasers do. So we'll just get rid of that, and that, and that, and that. And then next up, we'll get rid of this nose cone piece here, these braking engines. And then these two single HAB modules. So get rid of both of these. And we'll have to get rid of this because unfortunately you can't, while you can change this to different variants of the same type, you can't change it to the type that has more snap points this side of it. So we'll just delete that as well. So this is the parts that you're going to be keeping for El Cheapo version of this, the Lunar Whale. First thing though, take this grav drive and snap it here in place of the one structural part. And then we go to the back of the landing bay here and then attach a Tayo all-in-one berth mid, yeah, there we go, all-in-one berth mid, except instead of the berth, we use the workshop so that we have all our crafting benches, and just snap that in place. And then we move these landing gear bits right here back by one, and then attach the cockpit right there. And then to here, we're going to attach a Hope 11 Docker 4. And that'll be our docking bay right there. And then right here, we're going to attach the Tayo all-in-one berth 2x1 top. And then, of course, move this equipment plate back to attach with the you know, be in line with these weapon mounts on the side. And apparently we still have an error, so we'll see what that is here in a second after I move this shield generator up to this point right here. So yeah, error, yeah, we need fuel tanks. So yeah, all right, so right, so this, so far, we're actually still in the green, even with buying like the two new HAB modules. So we need some fuel tanks. So go to fuel, couple options here. If you want to like be like super cheap, you can go with these Titan 450, which will give you 210 fuel. But it's probably worthwhile to just spring for a little bit extra for the 550. And then for cargo space, again, can just throw on these V-102 cargo holds. And then because their mobility is just tanked due to that, just go here and add on our MN3 engine. course, here place a again for El Cheapo version. You can go with these PB30 electron beams, or if you have enough credits, you can go with straight up with the Ravager. Ravagers, but either way, it's going to be an upgrade. So let's just go with the cheapest option here. And then here we add the Atoatl 270 missile launchers. And then add one to the back top here. Oh, wait, hang on. Oh, skip the step. Need to add an equipment plate first. And then add the missile launcher. So yeah, the error that we're getting is due to the not assigning the weapons. So just go in here and assign the electron beams to weapon one and assign the missile launchers to weapon two. And there we go. For 35,000 credits, got ourselves a decent ship with decent cargo capacity and decent jump. There are ways to further reduce the cost. Like, you could say swap these out with the cheaper, lighter fuel tanks, or maybe reduce the number of weapons a bit. But that's how much it'll cost you to do the El Cheapo version. If you want to do the super deluxe version like what I got, it's going to be a little bit more. So to replace this with the R2000, I think it is. Yeah, R2000 grab drive. And then replace this reactor, which this is actually a pretty good reactor for default on a ship with 18 power. Replace that with the 134mm toroidal reactor. But as you can see, that starts getting expensive after a while. I actually upgraded mine in several successive stages, but even with, like, you know, the cheapest version of it, well, let's just see how much it's gonna cost to, like, fully upgrade this thing. Yeah, so to get the same exact ship that I have, it's going to cost you like 74,000 credits total. But like I said, you can kind of roll these upgrades out. Oh, wait, right, I forgot the weapons. So yeah, over 81,000 credits. But still, this ship can take on four ships at once with this configuration. Oh wait, actually no. One last thing, get rid of this shield generator, which is not too horribly bad. And where's the shield generators? Yeah, add this 30S protector. So 87,000 credits, and you got yourself a ship that can take on ships that are at least one. Well, actually, one very, very last thing. Add this engine strut here for looks. Although this is completely optional, mind you. And unavailable at this star system. So yeah, and besides, it only costs, these things only cost a couple hundred. So basically, yeah, this is pretty much the exact same thing as the Lunar Whale for, let's just say, 87,000 credits. But keep in mind, this thing can take on four Crimson Fleet pirate ships at once and win. And it can also take on, like, groups of, like, what do you call them? Spacers and ecliptic mercenaries, where I wasn't able to capture. I disabled the ship, boarded it, killed the crew, and went to capture them. And it was like, oh, your piloting skill's not high enough. And when you get that error, that means it's either a Class B or Class C ship. So this thing can punch at least a full tier above its weight, because, you know, this is a Class A ship. So I'm just gonna discard the changes, because I'm probably just gonna sell this ship here, or just add it to, like, my trophy fleet, because, like I said, unless I need, like, a dedicated cargo hauler for trade routes, because I'm not sure how those are set up, I'm just going to keep using this ship right here. So, yeah, anyways. That's the first ship build that I've, you know, custom ship build that I've done. I'm really happy with how it turned out. It's been a great ship so far.
It's coming and going all the time.
So, anyways, I hope to have some more of these ship build videos out, you know, over time. Also, I'm not, you know, giving up or banning any of my Fallout 4 videos. I will be getting some of those done here, you know, in between these, you know, especially once the whole new game thing kind of, like, fades out and I start, you know, needing a break from Starfield. But anyways, I hope you all enjoyed it, and until next time, this is DJ Bonebreaker signing off.